Today, we're going to talk about the lessons from Deming, or as I call it, mastering the concept of optimization and learning how to get the highest and the best use of your time, your effort, opportunity, access, capital, human capital, market. So, of the many giants I've had the great honor and pleasure of working with, contributing to, and learning from, W. Edwards Deming's organization ranks amongst not only the most influential, but the most impactful upon me as well. This segment from one of the many three-day programs we've done in Tokyo, and so you know it, we've done 5 or 6 programs in Tokyo, we've done 6 programs in China, we've done 40 programs in Australia, we've done 20 programs in the UK, and I've chosen different segments from the ones that are the most impactful. This one from Tokyo discusses how we use many of the Deming lessons. And you all should know that Deming was a very remarkable contributor to your industrial might, and he taught how to do process improvement and quality control, but mostly on the manufacturing side. Well, when I worked with him, I learned his methodology and figured out how to apply it to the revenue generating side, how to identify all the different processes, all the different elements, all the different overlooked factors that make a big difference in generating more and sustaining revenue that most businesses don't see, and how to first of all identify what they are, recognize how they're currently performing, and make them perform better and better and better. And that's going to be the theme of most of what we will cover here. And it's very exciting because it's very, very logical. Do you all know how Deming did it for manufacturing? Anybody not know how Deming did it? I'll give you the simple. He's got a very simple philosophy. It was complicated, but first thing you want to do is analyze variation, and then you want to raise the bar and you want to constantly improve it. He would look at manufacturing. He would say, okay, there's 25 people doing the same function. Let's break down all the separate processes in that function and see how each one is performing. Maybe one person produced 50% more production every hour than everybody else. Maybe somebody else had one half of the scrap or the rejects. Maybe somebody else had 1/4 of the downtime. His or her machine didn't break down. And on and on. And Deming would try to figure out, what does that person do or know consciously or subconsciously that's making them 50% more productive, or making them have half of the breakdowns, or making them produce twice the quality? And he'd figure that out, and then he'd teach those to everybody. And so each person would learn how to be 10% better here, 50% better here, 80% better here. And the combination was hundreds or thousands of percent. And that's how he transformed, really. It's simple. I mean, it's much more complicated. That's how he transformed your industrial might, whenever it was, 70s or 80s. Well, the same thing is appropriate for revenue generation. First thing you have to do is figure out what is generating revenue. Then you have to break it out into its current elements and other elements you're either not using, should use, and then you got to figure out, how's it doing right now? Who is doing that better, in my company or somewhere else? Could I borrow what they're doing and make what I'm doing, instead of do this, do that? And can I do that 10 different ways? Because all of a sudden, that's how you get hundreds, even thousands of percent profit growth or client growth over a period of time, even in a bad economy.